11-2-H-4, the chair may postpone further proceedings to any other question approving a measure or adopting an amendment on which a recorded vote or the ayes and nays are ordered, and without objection, the chair is authorized to declare recess at any time. Today, the committee will consider H.R. 3409, Coast Guard Reauthorization Act of 2019, H.R. 2548, Hazard Eligibility and Local Projects Act, H.R. 2726, Banning Smoking on Amtrak Act of 2019, and H.R. 3362, Small Airports Mother's Rooms Act of 2019. The first item for consideration is H.R. 3409, Coast Guard Reauthorization Act of 2019. I now call up H.R. 3409, ask unanimous consent to discharge Subcommittee Coast Guard Maritime Transportation for the consideration of H.R. 3409, that it be considered as read and open to amendment at any point without objection, so ordered. No objection. I'm pleased to speak in favor of this bill. Again, in the tradition of the committee, bipartisan legislation to reauthorize funding for the United States Coast Guard and the Federal Maritime Commission for years 2020 and 2021, and address other important issues raised by maritime stakeholders. I'm pleased to have ranking member, minority member Sam Graves, and chair and ranking minority member on Subcommittee on Coast Guard and Maritime Transportation, respectively. Sean Patrick Maloney and Bob Gibbs joined me on this important legislation. They contributed mightily to the product, and I appreciate the work they've done and their staff has done. In fact, you know, we have worked extensively to include in this legislation several bipartisan bills introduced by other members of this committee from both sides of the aisle, and I want to thank them as well for their cooperation. As we know, the Coast Guard has suffered from insufficient budgets for a number of years, mostly as a byproduct of mandatory cuts imposed by the stupid Budget Control Act. This legislation reverses that trend. I am pleased to note this legislation provides increased authorized funding levels of over $11 billion for the Coast Guard's discretionary budget for fiscal years 2020-2021. The authorized funding levels track increased appropriations over the past two fiscal years and build in an annual consumer price index increase of 2% to arrive the highest authorized funding levels for the Coast Guard in recent memory. I'm particularly pleased top line numbers for procurement, acquisitions, and improvement have been pushed up to 2.7, 2.8 billion respectively, which should enable the Coast Guard to maintain all its ongoing recapitalization programs, including progress on building the new polar security cutters and additional funding to address the $2.7 billion backlog, shoreside infrastructure and deferred maintenance. Considering the strain and uncertainty the Coast Guard has experienced over the past year due to the government shutdown, authorized funding levels in this legislation will provide some welcome relief and provide a needed degree of certainty. I also support the modest $1.4 million increase in the annual operating budget of the Federal Maritime Commission. Last Congress, this committee passed the most extensive package of amendments to the Ocean Shipping Reform Act since 1998, principally to address the need for greater antitrust oversight of foreign flag commercial carrier alliances that transport more than 98% of U.S. foreign commerce. The modest increase of $29 million for the FMC's operating budget should provide the Commission with additional resources it needs to be an effective cop on the beat and ensure all carriers abide by fair shipping practices, compliance with all antitrust requirements, which they haven't been doing. I'm also pleased that this legislation makes a strong affirmative statement in support of the Jones Act as it applies to maritime transportation, heavy lift activities that occur offshore. We need to be doing everything we can to encourage and facilitate growth in the maritime sector of our economy, especially our coastwise trades and shipbuilding. I believe language in this bill strikes a sensible path forward, which provides both clarity on the reach of the Jones Act and certainty for offshore industries reliant on heavy lift vessels. I urge members on both sides to support this provision. In closing, allow me to once again thank Ranking Member Sam Graves, as well as Coast Guard Subcommittee Chairman Maloney, Ranking Member Gibbs, for their cooperation drafting this important legislation. Look forward to our continued collaboration as this legislation moves forward. I now recognize Subcommittee Chair Maloney to explain the bill.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd like